New movie Greed, all about a billionaire fashion mogul on the brink of losing it all. Look at that. It is brilliantly played by Steve Coogan, who's here. And amazingly directed by Michael Winterbottom, who's also here. Gents, nice to see you both. My understanding is you wanted to use real names.
Is that true?
No, it's a fiction. It's a fiction. Steve plays a guy called Rich McCready. There is a connection to a real retail fashion tycoon, but this is a fiction.
Okay.
But I mean, there are real people out there like the guy I play, who's kind of like ostentatious, unapologetic, and quite vulgar. But you know, that's how a lot of billionaires get their money, not just through hard work.
But that's what I was going to say. Do you think there is a requirement to have certain personality characteristics to get to this level?
I think some of the characters they have enable them to be sort of tenacious and have a lot of alacrity. But there are also characteristics that mean that people can often get bullied and people get subjugated, like the people who work in the developing world. Because what we're saying in the movie is really there's a link between the super rich and the super poor. A lot of these billionaires are worth Walmart is like 180 billion, Zara is like 70 billion, and then the people who work in the factories making the clothes, they're getting paid things like $3.50 a day. So the movie really just makes that connection about that huge disparity in wealth.
And then Michael, one thing that's interesting is now I think we're in a position where to some degree they're celebrities too.
Yeah, and I think with fashion, celebrities use it in a way to kind of like make it seem glamorous, to hide the reality. So when you go into a store and you buy your $10 dress, your $20 dress, you see pictures of beautiful women or famous celebrities like Beyonce or Kate Moss or Kylie Minogue, and you think you're buying a bit of that glamorous, beautiful world, when really what you're doing is buying the work of a woman in Sri Lanka on £4 a day, or the woman of a worker in Bangladesh on $3 a day. And if you thought about the women who actually made it, if the posters on the shop were the people who made it, then maybe you would have a slightly different attitude to the clothes you were buying.
No question about that. We're going to look at a clip in a second. It references Kylie Jenner. There are glamorous elements to this. You shot this all in Mykonos, or?
Well, we shot it on Mykonos. We also shot in Monaco on, it was quite odd because, like, one week we're shooting on super yachts in Monaco that where we had to rent for, like, $150,000 a day. Right. And then the next week we're shooting in Sri Lanka in these garment factories where people are paid, like, $4 or $5 a day. So a big contrast.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Isla Fisher is in this too. Take a look.
Where are the children?
Finn sleeps all day. He's pale. He looks like a vampire. And Lily was here, but she's gone off with the reality TV show. Oh,
what's all that about? Why would you want your life splashed all over the telly, Francois?
Beats me.
Well, I think it's pretty good for her, actually. It gives her something to do and it keeps her grounded.
Her grounded?
Yeah. If you look at the Kardashians, Kylie Jenner's got over 1 billion Instagram followers. She's on the cover of Forbes.
Well, then she must be a very good person, very successful.
She's richer than you, sweetie. And she's
worth it. That's not true, is it?
Yes, it is. It's actually
true. That can't be true.
She's richer than you.
Is that a push-up bra or are they new?
Are those teeth fake? Put them in a glass. Pick them out.
Yeah, because it costs 20 grand.
Man.
There you go. Hilarity ensues. Part of the thing is you celebrate a birthday party there?
Yeah. I mean, the whole thing is about a big birthday celebration where these billionaires, particularly the one that we're loosely based on in England, they throw these lavish parties that cost. In actual fact, they spend millions on a single party, and they hire these movie stars and pop stars to turn up to their parties, and also which kind of legitimizes the more nefarious side of their business interests. But the money that's spent on a party of a guy called Sir Philip Green in England, the money he spent on his birthday party was more than the budget of the movie we made.
So wow.
But on the other side of it, can you know the average citizen walk into Target or whatever and know whether this was made in a sweatshop or whether this, how can we consciously buy, you know?
The thing is, the film is kind of satire on the whole system. It's not saying there's one bad guy or one bad firm. This is how it all works. You know, all the clothes you buy in the high street are made in countries like Sri Lanka where we filmed, or Bangladesh, or Myanmar, or Vietnam, and the reason is because the wages are about $3 or $4 or $5 a day. You know, so you can't individually as a consumer change things. You have to try and collectively, politically say, let's change the rules, just let's make the system a little bit fairer, let's increase the wages overall. Yeah. It's not like feeling guilty like I'm buying something on the high street, I'm guilty, because you can't get away from it, the whole system.
Exactly,
like
everything you buy is. Yeah.
Well, opening our eyes and making us laugh as well, Greed opens, Landmark Theatre, Arclight in Hollywood, it opens today. Gents, good to see you both. Thanks very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.